What's up, everyone? WizardKen here with another Xbox 360 World of Tanks map video. Today we're going to be talking about Pearl River. We're going to be going over it, and we'll be talking about the strategies that I use in the game on the Xbox 360 version of World of Tanks. Now, the reason why I say it like that is because you PC players of World of Tanks, please be advised that sometimes the Xbox version is played differently than the PC version of World of Tanks. And what I mean by that is sometimes the 360 guys like to change it up a little bit and do different things than what you guys do on the PC version. And so I highly suggest you go and check out somebody else's channel, like Quickie Baby. He does really nice map reviews on the PC version. The other thing is you 360 viewers, guys, remember these are my strategies. This is just what I do when I'm playing these maps. Now, the reason why these take me so long to make is because I like to study how you guys play the maps. And what I mean by that is, you know, when a new map comes out that I've played on the PC, I'm like, oh, I'm so excited. And I try running the old paths that I use on the PC, and sometimes they work, and then sometimes they don't. And that's my problem with trying to get these map videos out as quickly as possible, is that I don't want to do it too quickly that you guys, learn my strategy and then it completely fucks up on you. My strategy right now might completely fuck up on you, but at least I've studied. I usually take about 30, 50 games before I start really figuring out a strategy to work on a map, because I need to sit there and see the consistency of where people are going versus what they do on the PC, and then work out a new strategy that way. And that's why it takes me so long to do these map videos, or at least bring one out. So, that being said, this is going to be based off of what I've observed in the 360 version. Of course, guys, every game is different. It's never going to be the same always, but there are consistencies that you could see majority of the time. Sometimes your team is like full retard, and they all go one way, and then the strategy never works. But anyways, hopefully these will help you guys out on understanding the maps a little bit, the different point of views that I like to look at and go for in different tanks, and hopefully this will help you out. So without further ado, we're going to be looking at this map as a standard battle. Of course, there is, I believe, encounter and then also assault on this one. If I remember right, there is assault, but I can't completely remember because it's been so long since I've had this map as like an assault. That's why I can't even remember if there is one, but I do remember there is an encounter and there is a standard battle with this. And the reason why I want to do standard is because assault or encounter on this one is really a one-sided game. It really sucks for the opposite team, and we'll just cover them real quick, because usually the encounter flag is right here. And the thing that sucks about this, and we're going to cover this on the regular map video, is that this ridgeline is what I like to call is Death Valley for anybody that's in this vicinity trying to capture the flag. Now, there are some buildings that block the view of these guys over here, but a lot of it's pretty seen, and it's very hard for people that are trying to capture the flag from this side over here. So, anyways, that's my whole point on the encounter parts, is that it's really one-sided, and I think the flag should be in a different spot. Wargaming should really address this issue. Alrighty, so continuing with the standard battle, of course, our flag of our team that we're going to be choosing is starting up top. And the flag on the enemy team is starting at the bottom right corner. Now, the reason why I wanted to choose the top is because this is one of the best starting positions, I think, anyways. The bottom is nice, but I really like the top. And we're going to talk about that Death Valley area, or Death Shooting Spot, Sniper Spot, whatever you want to call it, area. And it's really nice to have control of this area right here. So first off, we're going to be talking about pretty much every single tank all at once. Light tanks will be a little bit different. Artillery, of course, is going to be different. But your mediums, heavies, and your tank destroyers, especially since we have the new AMX, you know, the French line out, which are really supportive world tanks. We're going to include the heavy tanks in our discussions with certain spots on here. So let's go ahead and start off. Alright, so we're going to be playing as, we'll just say, a medium, heavy, and a tank destroyer. Now, you see a lot of your friends coming up this way, towards this way, and then you also see a couple guys possibly going through the mountain pass, and then possibly going around this way. You hardly ever see anybody, and we're going to just mark this in red, going this way through the town. Usually it's the enemy team that likes to scoot through town a little bit. And we're going to go ahead and mark some of the positions that these guys like to go. And then also where they like to end up, usually like the heavy tanks. And then you'll see some heavy tanks end up in here. And this includes medium tanks too. I'm just not going to fill this whole screen up with so much garbage that you guys can't keep it going. And then you'll have some heavy tanks here. This will represent heavies and mediums throughout the whole process, just so you guys know. Tank destroyer symbols are always just going to be tank destroyers. And then, of course, arties are going to be artillery. Now, we'll put the artie right here because, to be honest with you, this side sucks for artie because there's not a lot of coverage. We'll put our artie here. Alrighty, so like I was saying, mediums and heavy tanks, you'll see them go certain paths. Sometimes tank destroyers, depending on what they are, like T-95s, FVs, 183s. Tanks like that that have a superior armor, T-110 E3s, usually will go the same paths as heavies and mediums because they're, you know, they're very strong, they're very aggressive tanks. They're the pushers. They're there to help support the mediums and heavies, but they also can be brawlers in the sense of being able to get in there and fight because of their armor levels that they have. Anyways, so we're going to focus on the path over here to the far left, which a lot of people may or may not go to. Now, I said this was like the sniping area. And I also forgot this area up here, which is my main point. But this is called, the death area, the sniping, the Reaper area. This is not where you usually will get killed, but this is an area that you can do a lot of damage and destroying a lot of people. I usually don't play too much on this lower area, but I have seen people do it and have done a lot of serious damage. But I like coming up here with my medium or heavy, you know, or my tank destroyer, whatever. And I like sitting up here. We're just going to mark this as a tank destroyer because really we're focusing on those sniper groups, which are majority of the time tank destroyers. But I'm going to include the French heavies and mediums in there too because they have a decent sniper ability too. And this is a cool spot to be because why? You have a huge area of view. I really want to change the color real quick, just so I can represent this a little bit differently. Now, you've got, actually, to be honest with you, you've got a view of this entire area. So this whole area, except for the middle area, this road, this mountain pass here, basically all through here, you have a view of. Now, not per se that you're going to be able to spot everybody in there. No, this advantage point is great to be able to shoot at people that your teammates have spotted. You're going to be able to shoot a lot of people in this area. I believe the max range is out here somewhere, which is like the 600, 700 meter range. But in here is going to be the golden area. I love sitting up here. There is a big boulder that you can use as protection. There's not a lot of cover up there at all. So make sure you have your camo nets on, guys. There's no real bushes to use at all. There is a nice spot right in there that has some tree coverage. But to be honest with you, I like sitting right on the edge because it gives me a view of One, these guys that like to come up into the area I like to call the chokehold area, or the bottlenecked area. We know all about those areas. Those are pretty much where tanks gather, and they can't maneuver very well, and you could just shoot them up. But look at this. You've got this whole area that you could protect. I mean, if, you know, the enemy team pushes from one area or another, you have full range of shooting at them. Now, you might have to reposition a little bit to spot these guys if there's no one down here to spot. Usually, you have already left that helps spot for a few minutes before they get killed. But look at this. You have this whole area to spot. Now, the town's a little difficult. And like I said, the middle area, you're not going to be able to do too much. But once they get up to here, you're going to have an easy time shooting at them. There's a little pass right here that you can shoot at them. And the city, you could shoot a little bit here and there. There's little spots that you could shoot and kill people from. But really, look at this advantage point, guys. It's pretty much an entire area of the map that a lot of people go. I mean, I've killed tons of people trying to pass through the river area. I've killed tons of people trying to sneak up on our flank, especially if no one goes this way. This is a really, really, really good hold down position. Now, you are going to be open for whenever anybody spots you. And it's usually because of somebody in the town right here that made it past your firing squad. That's going to spot you on the hill, and they're going to take shots at you. And then already, of course, down here, they're going to say, hello, I want to troll on you and kill you. And that's the bad, you know, advantages of having this area. But look at this spot back here. We're going to mark this in red. Look at this spot back here. There's a drop off. I know it's a lot of clustered. You can't really see it. But this dark area is actually a drop off. It's a mountainside, a hillside that you could drop down. So if you get spotted, guys, just drop down it. And then you could come straight back up and resume what you were doing once the threat is gone. This is what I do all the time. You guys have seen me in the E25 videos with Bubba. You guys seen me on the live stream. Always go to this area, no matter what I'm really driving. Because it is a badass spot. I usually do really well here. Excuse me, I got the hiccups. I always have like the hiccups or something when I'm recording. anyways, this is a very nice spot to go. And I love it a lot. And I really suggest you guys that... you know, or tank destroyers, or have the French line where you have really good accuracy. This is great for you because you are going to be shooting long range. The other point is that I want to make out is you guys see it all the time. This is why we put the tank destroyer up here, because they like to sit up there and snipe at your buddies that are down in here, and they also like to snipe at you. But usually, your buddies are traveling up this way and they spot these guys. Once they get up to this bottlenecked area, they'll spot these guys and you have free range of shooting them up, which is really, really nice. So look for this area, guys. Try it out. Let me know what you think about it. I like it a lot because you know, you're protecting a lot of your pals. You can switch from one area to another pretty easily. Now, we talked about, you know, the sniping area up here with the heavy tanks. We're going to focus on here. I know I deleted a lot of the past because I don't want to have a lot of cluster on the screen. But here we are. Here's our bottlenecked area. Mark this all in green. And of course, you see this happen all the time. The enemy comes up here and you're having a battle back and forth right here. This is where you guys are like popping in and out and shooting. Hopefully you have guys up here helping you out. But if you don't, guys, back away. There's a reason that they have these bottlenecks here. It's, you know, you want to sit there and shoot up all these guys. You're just like, oh man, I'm not going to back down. I'm an E75. I'm a T-110E5. I'm an IS-7. I can handle a lot. I'm an FE. You know, and you guys are badasses, don't get me wrong. But this is the problem. You're going to sit here and you're going to have four or five tanks shooting at you when you're trying to squeeze through a small gap. Don't do that. Just stay back. All I do is I pull off to this side spot, which protects me from any dumbass tank destroyer that's trying to shoot at me. Protects me from Arnie. And then once these guys start pulling through, start shooting them in the sides. Start shooting those lower plates. Let them come through. Don't build up right here. I hate this. Plus, guys, if you have your tank destroyers up here, that's twice the amount. of bullshit. They're going to be focusing either on you or your tank destroyer buddies. They're not going to know what to do. And we've done this over and over again, and we've kicked ass every single time because people just, I don't know what it is. They just want to continue to come through that area and keep fucking them over. So, anyways, so that's my whole spot on this area here. Just be patient and let the enemy come to you. Alrighty, guys, so once you get past this point, you've killed a lot of people. Just remember, make sure you look up here. Usually by this time, the tank destroyers have retreated and they're heading back to another spot. Just be, you know, aware of this. Also, be aware of any enemy tanks that could possibly be in the city still. While you're traveling this path, because you are going to be exposed to anything here, and also any enemies that might be getting pushed back from your buddies that are coming up the middle area. But basically what you're going to do is just keep traveling through this area. Always stay in the outer road. Don't go on the inner road unless there are people down here that you want to shoot at. The only reason why is because this will protect you from anybody else spotting you, and you could possibly catch Artie off guard once you get around this pass through here. It's very good coverage, and I highly suggest you taking that path if you've taken this outer ring area. Might as well just keep following the road all the way around. Alrighty, so now that we've talked about this path right here, as you can see, I didn't say anything about going in the water. Don't go in the water. Just stay away from it. Even if you're running away, either hold down and just shoot at people as much as you can until you die, or you know, try to run away a different way. Don't go in the water. You're going to slow down way too much. I don't care what perks you have on your tank. You're going to be slow as fuck going through the water. Now, we're going to talk about going in the mountain pass. The reason why I even talk about doing this, because some of you guys are probably thinking, why don't you just stay back here and snipe? If these guys have to come around here, you're going to have them in the open. The reason why is because if the enemy does take this road right here and they drop down, unless you have snipers here that are holding these guys down, they're going to get into the city and then they're going to creep up and eventually be able to surround you on that mountain path. You do need everybody on this map to go different ways. You cannot have just one set of people going one way and that's it, because you're going to get fucked on the flag. You really are. So anyways, talking about the middle road. Now there's two ways you go. You go this way or you go up this way. I suggest going up the second route that I was showing right here. Now, just like down here, this is a huge bottleneck. Not only is this a nasty spot, Artie can hit you. I didn't say that down here, but Artie can hit you here. Artie can hit you here. This is a nasty spot because Artie does sit up here sometimes and around here. You know, they're going to have perfect shots on you. So be careful with what you do up here. Now, unlike the other area that we were talking about, there's not really a pullback position that you can allow your snipers to help you with. To be honest with you, once you're in this area, this is all, you're all on your own. What I do in this situation when I'm in my medium or heavies, I try to figure out how many people are out there. So what I'll do is I'll sacrifice some of my life. I'll pull out a little bit just to see if there's one or two heavies, three heavies, so on and so on. Trying to get a number of what's going on. Once I know there's, we'll just say there's two heavy tanks, and it's me, Bubba, and Roy. They have no idea that Bubba and Roy are there. I like to make sure that people stay back about right here, in this area right here, and wait for me to tell them to come up. Because you want to get these heavy tanks that are coming, these two heavy tanks, to get into this wide area, okay? The reason why you want this before you get your friends to come in is because that Y area, that intersection right there, is the biggest opening that you're going to have in this upper area. Now, why do you want that? Well, this is the reason. We have three tanks there too. And what we want to do, especially if they're E-100s coming up, we want to flank them. We want to get into positions where we're going to hurt them the most. And once they get up to this area right here, that's when everybody attacks at once. Yes, you're going to receive damage. You're probably going to suffer. You're probably going to die too. But you're going to do a lot of damage to these two individuals. You're going to be flying around this way, flying around this way, and then someone's going to come up the middle. That's three ways of attacking two tanks. You're going to have good advantage points. Now, say they start kicking your ass, and you guys aren't doing as much as you really wanted to against the guys. Maybe some backup came up. Look at your retreat points. You've got a retreat point here, here, and then also the way you came down. I highly suggest not going the same way you came down, just because they're going to be pushing hard. If you can get around these turns and then lose them inside this area, it's cool. Also, if you could drop off the edge, even better. Just get you out. But remember, these are hide-walled areas. Not a lot of area to go and get away. So, that's my whole perspective on the top area. But, really, you guys are probably wondering, where do you go after that? Do you go down here? It really depends. I mean, if your guys that came up this way are gone, and these heavy tanks, medium tanks, tank destroyers are going to start pushing, they're either going to come up, they're either going to come up this way and this way. They're probably going to split up, which is actually good for you because now you have less tanks to deal with. Usually at this point, this is when I decide, is my flag going to be captured before I get theirs or what? Usually what I do, we'll just say the flag's going to be captured. I don't come up this way and try to confront the enemy. Reason why? They're going to be expecting it, especially if they've seen that you've been fighting some of their heavies. Don't go there. Okay? I mean, you could try it if you're a badass, big-ass tank. Like an E-100, if you want to hold them down here, that's awesome. I mean, we'll just put an E-100 right there, and he's going to be holding them down. You other quick tanks, take the road around, guys. Take the road around. Your E-100 should be able to handle it for a while, especially if you have two tanks there. Handle it for a while, even if it's just one tank coming around the rear. Come up, shoot them up. Okay, after you're done with that, the cool thing is, okay, you've got these heavy tanks that are coming through this watered area. They're going to be slow. Take advantage of that slowness, okay? Let them get into this watered area, and then you've got, after you destroy these guys, come down here, start attacking them. Use your movement, your speed to get in and out of cover, shoot these guys, and run away. While your other buddies are coming up behind them, you've got the enemy pinned down in the water, they have nowhere to go, and you kill them. Now, the other way you could go is, say that no one went up here, say your team is pushing, they destroyed these guys, and they're pushing across, they're going to push across the bridge. You are going to want to go up here. This is your next sniping point. This is very nice to do. Now, you guys that don't snipe very well, E-100s and stuff like that, have big derpy guns, I suggest you going through here and then starting to get to the flag and stuff like that. You're going to be exposed, but hopefully by this time, you've got your other TDs up here. You've got your other heavy tanks that can, you know, have a decent sniping, or medium tanks. And they're, you know, they're starting to snipe and take out whatever resistance you have up here. And then also these guys up top are going to come in and start wiping up whatever is left. Because I've seen a lot of enemy tanks. Once we push to about this point, they're here. They're hiding in these areas right here. They're dipped areas, so they're hoping that Artie can't hit them. But really, to be honest with you, it's a terrible spot to be because they can't really aim up too much on these highest points. So you snipers can be a distraction while your heavy tanks come around and flank these guys, take them out. Also, wait for your other team up north to be able to come down and attack from the rear also. Alright, so we talked about the middle road. Now, the outside road, this is going to be a very quick thing. Really, to be honest with you, there's only one route to really go, and it's this way towards the flag. But there are some things you need to know. Sometimes the enemy team likes to hold down about right here, you know, and it may, sometimes a little bit further up. But a lot of times I see them hold down right here because they've got areas to cut in and out and try to kick your ass. This is where, you know, use the map to your advantage, okay? Now this is an open area, so you got to be careful if you come up this way, but you could come up this way and try to flank, have multiple tanks shooting at different directions. They're not going to be able to angle in every single direction. You're going to be able to get them at some point. Or you could do what I like to do. It does take a lot longer to do, But you could swoop around this way. The reason why I like doing that is eventually, once you get to this point, this is when they're going to see you. This is when you're going to get spotted. Hopefully nobody else spots you while you're coming around this pass. That's when they're going to see you and they're going to be like, oh shit, now we've got tanks here. And then while they're focusing on you, your buddies push up. Push up, and now you got multiple tanks. Yes, this is a bottleneck area, but once you get multiple tanks up here, these guys are going to fall back and keep retreating. Once you push this line, if there's no tank destroyers that are coming up this way from the middle section, I would highly suggest somebody coming up here and supporting the rest of the team, because once you get to this bridge, it is a very bad bottleneck. It is a bad position to be in. Once you get past this bridge, anybody that's out here as a tank destroyer, heavy tank, is going to destroy you. Okay, you're gonna want some support up on this hill, and then you just continue pushing until you get to the flag. Now, to be honest with you guys, there's not much more left to this entire town that I do. We could talk about the opposite side, but really it's the same factors. Guys, just do it and vice versa. The only difference is that you don't have that sniping perch. This is why I love this northern side, because you have those sniping perches through here. I mean, really, to be honest with you, there's only like really one sniping perch right here that can shoot out this way. But really, you don't have much to go with. The nice thing is that because you don't have a sniping perch, that means more tanks can back up these guys that are pushing this way towards the enemy. That means more tank destroyers that can back up these guys here, here, and here. So let's talk about arty and light tanks. First, arty, I'm going to tell you this, you're fucked. I mean, this is a nice open map, but there's a lot of hills. There's a lot of restrictions on what you could do. To be honest with you, there's a nice little hill back here, a little hole you can hide in. That's what I would do. Just hide in a hole, trying to get in some big spots. When you see the enemy starting to come, you're gonna be fucked. Eventually, you're gonna be pushed back here, and you're gonna be trapped and then killed. So not much Artie could do on this map. I haven't really found a position that really suits me the best, except for this area right here where I just shoot and do what I can. You could try getting on the hill, but I can tell you this, I usually get spotted and then shot. I usually killed. Light tanks. Now, this is a fun map for you light tanks, or really fast mediums. You know, like your M46 Pattons, anything like that that has some speed to it, T-71s, the E-25, I love doing, you know, fun scouting stuff with them. But really, this whole map is your playground. This is going to be so much fun for you guys. You just gotta remember your choke points. You know, here, here, and of course, pretty much all along this area here are your nasty choke points. And I forgot to include this area right here. You just gotta remember your choke points, guys. That's it. But once you guys get in your open ground, you're gonna be fine. You're gonna be able to do whatever you want. So, when I start out, you know, T-71, we'll just go with that. Of course, you know, your enemy tanks are going to be coming up here, here, and then also here. Let me draw my lines a little bit more, because I like drawing. You know what? If I decide to go up top, I cut through this middle area, because you don't have to go up a hill too much until you get about here. But you'll have enough speed built up when you're coming through here that you're going to pass all your buddies. So that's how I do it here. I don't go this route because as a light tank, you're going to get spotted by the other light tank that's probably traveling through the city. So come up through this way. And then once I get to right here, that's when I'm spotting whatever bastard's going up on a hill, the tank destroyer. And then I'm spotting these guys that are coming around. I whip back. That's when I start heading back. Now, what do I do from here? Sometimes I'll sit here and try to keep spotting until I see more tanks coming, or once I know enough tanks are coming, I cut through the town. The reason I do this is because these guys that are up here are probably looking for that little tank destroyer or that little scout that's trying to spot, and you can cut in and out of these buildings pretty easily enough and spot them. Once I'm done with that, I go and help whoever needs help, either going up the middle or coming up this road and helping out these guys. Now, once I'm done with that, if I don't go this way, I rarely ever just go up the middle area. Just because I don't like it as much, I'm not as good as it as most people. But the nice thing I've seen a lot of people do is once they see these guys, they haul ass and they do a big circle. And then they come back and then head back this down this road. The reason why is because they're spotting people here. They're spotting people that might be really slow, like your T95s, right through here. They're spotting all these guys through here that are, you know, setting up. And then they get the hell out of there. And they might do a couple circles. Or they come back and they start sniping, or, you know, they just try to be productive. Really, to be honest with you, light tanks, you're kind of screwed in the sense of trying to get around people because of those bottlenecked areas. Until your team gets some of those guys taken down, it's really just those few minutes at the beginning is your time to shine. Nothing else, to be honest with you. I've had problems with, after I spotted people, I'm like, where the hell do I go now? I usually just go back up here and start sniping. And then I start moving again once some of these, depending on what side falls first, you know, I'll start traveling here and then I'll go get Artie as much as possible. Because honest with you, you're not going to be able to get Artie until probably midway or halfway through the game. Just because usually if Artie dies right at the beginning, it's because some weirdo on your team fucking sacrificed his life. He came through here and then he spotted Artie sitting up somewhere and then he's dead. And hopefully artillery on our team will shoot them and kill them. Alrighty guys, so the last way for light tanks that I like doing is pretty much going up this way. If you got enough time to make it here, this is your ending point of how far you should go. Right where it Y's off. The reason why is because usually by that time, either a medium tank or some kind of fast heavy is already up here. And the best thing to do is scoot this way. And hopefully you can make it back around. Spot these guys that are heading up this way and then run back down, because they're going to be, oh, and this is a good way to get these guys to follow you if your heavy tanks haven't gotten here yet, and then screw them over by all the snipers that are up here. These guys see you, they're like, oh, let's go kill them, and then they come down here and then they're dead because they've let themselves show in the open. Okay, couple spots I don't like traveling. If I am pushing onto the base, if I'm in the middle, actually, let me redo that, is this area right here. Reason why is because this is a big open area, and if they have tank destroyers here, and they're making their last stand, they're gonna be popping you like crazy. The best thing to do, guys, in this situation is maybe one person can distract them by popping in and out, but really, to be honest with you, the best form of attack to get to these flags is waiting for your buddies down here to push up, because then these guys are going to have to panic and then they're going to fall back, like I said, to these little tree line, to this little dip area. This is a nice bottlenecked area to surround them, and then that's when these guys underneath the bridge, which is great cover, guys, trust me, it's great cover, to push and get the flag. And then of course the enemy team is going to be like, oh, they're on the flag, they're going to go towards you. Your team is going to come up finally behind these guys, and then you're just going to connect together and blow them up in the middle. Alrighty guys, well that is the end of this video. I hope this helps you a little bit. I know this is a big open area and there's a lot of opportunities you guys think that you can go. You could try them. I've tried a lot of different ways, but usually in the end, the routes I've taken that I showed today are the best ones for me. And they usually work as long as my team is working. Like I said, if you have teams that are only going here and then in the middle and then nobody goes up top, you're going to fail. Or if your whole team just goes down this way, you're going to fail very easily, because the few guys that are up here trying to snipe and support this area, you're going to get overrun by the tanks coming around these other areas. It's just a terrible thing to do to your teammates. So try to this is where TeamSpeak works great, guys. If you're platooning, I understand just being in a party chat, but if you're not, try to be sociable, guys. Sit there and talk to your teammates. Say, hey guys, let's try to split off evenly, let's try to make sure that we have all the roads pretty much covered that they can come by, and then we'll readjust as we need to. because if you don't, you're going to get fucked over. And hopefully, one of those roads that you guys go down, the enemy team's not paying attention to, and you're able to, come around the enemy and help support your brothers that are helping you out, helping your team out. So, anyways, guys, I'm WizardKen. The other thing I would like to announce real quickly is, yes, once again, my schedule got changed for work. So, we were supposed to do live streaming tonight. It's not going to happen because I have to work again tonight. Apparently, the schedule that was put up on the bulletin board was different than the schedule that my soups had at their desks. So, unfortunately, my supervisors were like, oh, well, I guess we'll see you tonight kind of thing. They wouldn't give it to me off. So, I'm going to be working tonight. We are going to be live streaming. That means tomorrow and then Wednesday. So, it'll start about 5 p.m. Mountain Time. Now, on Wednesday, I might start it sooner just for you guys in Europe can watch, too. And no, guys, I haven't decided when and how I'm going to do a live stream with you guys in it. I don't know how I'm going to do that yet. Just because there's too many different situations that I can think of that I can't solve yet. I've had problems in the past where people don't respect the rules that I give out. And so that might cause problems with, especially since it's a live stream. Whatever happens, whatever's said, and this and that, comes back to bite me in the ass. I can't just edit it out. So, anyways, guys, I'm WizardKen. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think. I'll be doing more videos as I get a chance to do them with the maps. I'm still working on the AMX 5120. I'm trying to get the 120mm that it unlocks. And then also, we are about, a quarter of the way to the T110E4. I've been really pushing on the T30 a lot because I fell in love with that tank. I really have. I've been using it a lot, and I've actually neglected the AMX 5120. Which is actually a good thing because I actually neglected a lot of the T110E4 line when I was going up that line because I really got tired of it because it was such fucking bullshit trying to run the same tank over and over again, and they were shit. Like the T25-2, I hated that tank. I'm sorry. And that's just my opinion, though. I mean, other people like it, but to be honest with you, the pen that was on that tank and the tier that it was, it needed to have a better gun and stuff like that. Anyways, guys, I'm WizardKen. I miss you guys. Thank you so much for watching my videos. Hit the like button. If you guys are new to the channel, thank you. Welcome for viewing. Hopefully, you guys will stick around. We're a huge community. We're growing a lot. And we like to support each other and help as much as possible. Anyways, guys, I'm WizardKen. See ya.